Is the case in part simply following the money, as I assume it is, but also are there people who were on the inside, have turned against John Edwards and are saying, this is what happened and this is why it happened and I was part of it?
Well, yes, most notably Andrew Young, who was central to his campaign, a personal assistant to Edwards, and he was very much involved in receiving the money. And in fact, the government says that one of the wealthy benefactors here, Rachel Bunny Mellon, the heir to the Mellon fortune, actually sent him a note, because in April of 2007, she was upset about the coverage of Edwards spending $400 on a haircut. So she said, you know, I was furious that people are attacking Edwards for this. And now I'm quoting from this note that's in the indictment. She says, it inspired me. From now on, all haircuts, et cetera, that are necessary and important for the campaign, please send the bills to me. It's a way to help our friend without government restrictions. So the Justice Department is saying this shows that the money that she ended up giving Edwards to help keep the mistress out of the public eye was in service of the campaign and to try to get around the campaign laws.
Is a prosecution, what kind of case do they have? And are you surprised that this indictment came down?
Well, there's been a big buildup here, so it wasn't surprising that it came down at the end. This is a case, there's a real paradox about this case. It is factually devastating. Who would want to present to the jury this guy whose wife was dying of cancer? He has this affair. He lies about it. He recruits his aide with this ridiculous idea of saying that he's the father, that Andrew Young for a while says he's the father of the child. I mean, the facts are appalling. But legally, I think it's a very problematic case.
A weak case for the prosecution.
Well, I don't know about weak, but it's problematic in the sense that there has never been, as far as I'm aware, a criminal prosecution based on violating the federal campaign law in this way. And these payments, at least, do not on the surface look like traditional campaign contributions. I mean, it may be that they were campaign contributions, but they didn't go through the campaign. The campaign didn't know about them. And I think there is a possibility that you could argue to a judge to throw out the case or to the jury to acquittal and say, look, you know, this was bad behavior by John Edwards. But whatever else it wasn't a violation of the campaign finance laws. That's a plausible argument.
That's
in
John Edwards' argument, is it not?
It certainly is.
But
this was not a crime.
Join us online at charlierose.com.